Hey guys, welcome back to Hashtag the World of Cool Features. I hope you guys are keeping absolutely safe and shall continue to do so. It's not like any of us don't have free time. Well, let me quickly show you the one extra step that I take to make sure that I get audio that doesn't peak on my Blackmagic Design Pocket Cinema 4K, and the tip applies on the 6K as well. Now you can apply this technique to any camera that can receive a stereo audio channel and lets you set levels to them individually. I of course have two pocket cinema cameras and it does take amazing video, but audio... yeah, audio not so good. The mic that I use for these vlogs is a Rode SmartLav Plus. And yes, it is a microphone that natively only works with smartphones, but this adapter and this extension cable lets me use this amazing lav mic with any camera that accepts a 3.5 TRS input. That's almost all DSLRs. In fact, this is one of the best sounding and most versatile audio kits for this price. And since this tip is also specific for these videos that I put on YouTube, I'd say you must check this mic out over other budget options if you are a casual digital content creator. So here's what I do. I go to the settings page, then I go to the audio subsection on page 1. I set the channel 1 source to be 3.5mm left mic and set the channel 2 source to be 3.5mm right mic. Then wear the mic where I would, you know, like here, and start speaking like how I would speak in the video. Next, you need to find the sweet spot where your normal loudness doesn't hit or barely hits the yellow zone for channel 1. As you can see, in my case, it's somewhere near 60-65%. Now, do the exact same thing for channel 2, but try not to hit or barely hit the red zone. So, as you can see for me, that's around 80-85%. Now, what does this mean? This technically means on the left channel, you're trying to hit minus 18 dBFS, and on the right channel, you're trying to hit minus 10 dBFS. Now, the subtle ups and downs in human speech are unpredictable, but...
I'm Batman.
Plus, I need to demonstrate as well. So, after counting to 3, I'm kinda going to be loud on purpose, of course. So, please take off your earphones if you're wearing them, or bring your volume down to 0. There will be a visual cue on when to bring it back up. Don't worry. So, I'm gonna start counting. 1, 2, 3. Ah! You see, I just got louder than usual. 3, 2, 1. So clearly the audio peaked, right? You saw it. And if you're doing this right now, you heard it too. Why? I warned you, didn't I? Let's continue the demo in DaVinci Resolve. That's my choice of NLE. Yours can be anything else. But more or less, the process is the same. Right-click the clip in the media pool, go to clip attributes, then go to the audio page. What you need to have is the left and the right channel pushed out individually on their own separate tracks. So just make sure that the two options for source channel dropdown, they are, you know, kind of different. Now one should be embedded channel 1, and of course the other must be embedded channel 2. Now usually you never have to fiddle with any of this, I mean, because all of this is set by default in Resolve. I just showed you the process in case you ever need to troubleshoot. Dragging the video onto your timeline will still give you a mono looking track, but right click anywhere near the track header pane and select convert to linked group. This brings both your channels out. Now remember, these are still stereo channels. If I play them solo one by one, if you're wearing your headphones right, you will hear one track on the left, the other track on the right. I drag both these tracks out onto two new tracks and convert them into mono. Because if you don't, inside these individual stereo tracks, they are going to be the left channel only. I mean, just check, put your headphones on. This is track 1. This is track 2. But once you make them mono, you get center field playback. You should use the track that shows higher decibel levels as your main dialogue track. But remember when I kind of shouted and, you know, I peeked at you? I'm really sorry, guys. I didn't mean to. And if I didn't have to, I wouldn't have. Anyways, when you arrive at such a moment wherein you have peaked, just chop this portion out from this track. And use the other track where, since you set the levels low, you haven't clipped. You might have to play a little with the levels to match them, but more or less it's the same tone, it's the same EQ, it's the same sonus stage. So this is what should have happened. 2, 3. Ah! You see, I just got louder than usual. But this is what you can get. 1, 2, 3. Ah! You see, I just got louder than usual. For controlled environment shoots like this vlog, I usually don't clip or, you know, lose audio, but that is how I always set my levels. It's the seatbelts and airbags conundrum. Your car has them, but you're always focused on never having to need them. So I literally play with my filming equipment every day and come up with such fun hacks. Let me know if such videos are of any value to you and thus worth making for me. Stay safe and I will see you soon.